I just ask you to reflect on the last 12 months, even if it's through the lens of your own AI company, based on what OpenAI has done.
Yeah, I think what has happened over the past 12 months is a democratization of AI, where I think everybody on the planet suddenly sees the opportunity that AI can bring and across pretty much every piece of software and every industry that's there. So I think the hype is real, and we're going to see this proliferate over the next, you know, the next couple of years.
You know, Caroline and I always want to approach this from a technology perspective. You have built your own foundation model, LLM. You call it Dialpad GPT. You did that yourselves, but there's always a choice, you know, go to OpenAI or
sure.
another open source platform. Why do it yourself?
Yeah, fortunately, we have been in AI for a number of years. Dialpad acquired my business, which was one of the first real-time speech recognition engines called TalkIQ in 2018. So fortunately, at that time, we sat on this proprietary data set. We had a team that knew about these technologies and how to leverage them, and it became really evident for us that, look, we don't want to have, when we talk about AI, we don't want to be a wrapper around a third-party API. We want to control our innovation. We want to control the price and the scalability and the accessibility of that. And so I think AI is a fundamental differentiation in the market, and we want to own that piece ourselves because we believe that we can provide a better and enhanced experience to every one of our customers.
And I think a lot of the wrapper companies have perhaps realized the reasoning behind that of late, Dan. But what about the competition? How much more fast and furious has it become for you in the last 12 months?
Absolutely. I think it's a talent war right now out there in terms of finding people that know how to leverage these technologies. You know, when you talk about AI experts that understand natural language processing and speech recognition and large language models, there's probably thousands of them. And that's going to obviously proliferate and step over the course of the next couple of years. But very much so, the worry that is out there is, look, do these large language models available as an API suddenly make AI easy for everybody? And I don't think that's the case. I think these large language models are good at some very horizontal use cases, but I think what you'll see play out over the course of this next year is proprietary large language models that are going to be industry specific and use case specific, similar to our approach at Dialpad.
What about big corporates' desire to actually build themselves too? And the fact that we now have open source and closed source offerings. Have you been impressed by the fact that certain CTOs wanted to do themselves? How have you found that sales discussion with some of the companies that you work with?
Yeah, I don't think there's a right or wrong approach at this moment in time. You know, fortunately for Dialpad, we had a team of experts and a proprietary data set and the know-how to do this. And I think, you know, some startups are going to approach a foundational model today through OpenAI or Anthropic or Inflection or Google Vertex. And I think that the question is going to be whether those foundational models are going to provide use case specific or industry.
Well, and the business as well, right? You know, you started your career at Google 2003. Everyone that I speak to, you in ad sales.
Yep.
Everyone I speak to at that time was like, well, we were kicking around the hacky sack and chatting about AI in a bigger picture way. Are we now going to make money from this venture?
Yep. And I think the case is, look, when you're talking about the biggest opportunity is, I think, in contact center and sales organizations to say, look, we can provide instant the ability to instantly infer customer satisfaction from any conversation, never send out a survey. We can guide people through conversations. We can automate the note taking into a system of record. And those are things that every business on the planet in sales and support struggles with.